some students to Monk Meditation, the show about monks in the world of Warcraft.
We're going to talk about the myriad of news coming out of BlizzCon leading into the launch of Warlords. Servers went down with a blackout kick, and we're going to help you level up. Coming up on Monk Meditation, episode 35.
Here's your host, Chai T.
Welcome back to Monk Meditation, the show all about monks in the world of Warcraft, and welcome to Warlords of Draenor. Miss Pandaria, I love you so much. However, you have definitely outstayed your welcome. And speaking of outstaying welcome, I'm outstaying this intro's welcome. Air, sir, how's it going?
Oh, doing well today. I'm happy to be in the server with no queue. And yeah.
Yeah, what was the biggest queue you got?
It was on, it would have been your Friday night, and I was about 3 hours on every peak.
Yeah.
But hey, got a lot done, did some cleaning, spent a lot of time cooking, and played a lot of Destiny, there we
yes.
go. Yes. But no, it's good, things are a little bit more back to normal, so hopefully everyone else who's listening and tuning in later, everything is experiencing similar luck.
Yeah. All right, Daikatsu, you still have Candle. That's good. How are things going?
I still
going?
Have Candle. Very, very good. I am going to miss Missa Pandaria as well, but I'm kind of happy to have an expansion in which Blizzard pretty much said, hey, you see that orc? Kill him. There's five more. Go get them too. All the orcs. All of them.
Down,
so many orcs.
Down
to
the orcs. All right.
So many orcs.
Guan Xu, sir, our horde emissary. How do you feel about killing orcs?
I love killing orcs. I'm a Tauren right now, so that's okay with me. I'm back in the tundra of New England, you know, after being in Cali. And there's another game in which I have to play a monk in, Overwatch, if anyone's
that's
been paying attention.
It's a new game.
The monk named after a horse.
Yes.
What the hell?
That was, I was sitting right next to your wife, who is avid horse person, and as soon as it announced Zenyatta, I saw her look on her phone going, wait, what?
That's a horse? I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Wait. Yeah, Zenyatta, the queen of racehorses. She was racing in a couple of years ago as a potential triple crown contender as a four-year-old mare.
And we honor her by building a robotic monk.
Are you sure Zenyatta didn't come first by some other like mythology name?
We searched everywhere, and the only other instance of Zenyatta we can find, which is where she got her name, is from an old Police album.
I'd go with that.
Yep. And then, what is it? We looked it up. There's currently 154 Zenyattas in World of Warcraft.
I wonder how many of those are new.
None of them are centaurs. I am disappointed.
I know, right?
Only seven are monks, though.
Only
so
seven monks out of 154? What?
Yeah.
Makes no sense.
But yes, if anyone listening can come up with a reason why that monk robot is called Zenyatta, other than we took the horse's name, let me know, because I'm dying to know where they came up with that name. It couldn't have just been like, that was a great horse. Zenyatta. Robot! Let's go! No.
Well, Zen.
Even Chris
monk.
Benson doesn't work that randomly.
Zen.
And Yatta!
Yatta! No.
Yes. All right. Well, let's check in with how WoW is now in
Storm. Earth.
And fire! Woo-hoo!
All right, Daikatsu, how is WoW going for you, sir?
It is fantastic. I hit level 100 this morning. And since then, I have been held up in my garrison desperately trying to come up with 2,000 garrison resources. And that's about it. I've run one dungeon, Skyreach, which you need in order to do your ring quest. And that went well at normal, despite the fact that at one point the paladin healer decided to just jump off the stairs and fall to his death. And I'm like, did I just see that? He just ran right off.
Funny,
I screwed up.
Funny story. The the play with the dev day during the beta, the only instance we got to run with the dev was a class designer who worked on Mistweavers, actually, funny enough. Playing a warrior, and we're going to the second boss of Skyreach, and he jumps off the edge and dies.
Yes, this is in fact the second boss of Skyreach. That happened.
Yep. And apparently that ledge needs a rail. Designer.
So you're lesson to take here is designer. That if you're in the second dungeon of Skyreach, there's no invisible holes. You're going to fall right off.
It's a real hole.
Yes, that is a real hole.
Okay. That is an actual hole. Death waits below. Yes. Do not jump.
So if a Blizzard employee can fall off, anybody can fall off, right? So, especially if you're having too much tiger eye brew. All right. Air, how is WoW going for you?
Busy. Getting leveling up to 100. I think mid 95 right now. You know, with a couple days being off. getting the glyph factory going.
Dempsey's.
And just enjoying the music, enjoying the story. You know, hitting the feels every now and then. So it's been good. I'm really enjoying it so far.
Yeah. Yeah, I have really enjoyed the storytelling thus far. I'm only mostly through Gorgon, so I haven't gotten too far into it. But Shadowmoon Valley, not quite up to the level of storytelling as Jade Forest, in my opinion, but pretty darn close.
Way better than Jade Forest.
Oh, come on now.
I'm with Air.
Definitely better.
No.
For sure.
You guys are all smoking crack. Jade Forest was a great story.
I'm not even a Draenei anymore, and I know it was better than Jade Forest.
Sorry, I forgot about the scene in Shadow Moon Valley where suddenly I'm a sniper trying to take out little squirrels or something.
Yep, definitely better. Better than Jade Forest.
That was something weird. The ending of Jade Forest was pretty cool, and about three or four quests before that was pretty cool, but there was literally one part where it's like, hey, we need you to go in this cave and clear out worms.
Mm-hmm. Right.
What? Whereas in Shadow Moon Valley, it's like, guys, you better hurry. There is a dark star that is going to be summoned by Ner'zhul, and you have to stop him.
Spoilers.
Hey, we didn't say whether he stopped him or not. Yeah. Okay. Anyways, Guanxu, how's WoW going for you, sir?
Oh, man, it's going great. Putting a bunch of time in, about 99 and a half-ish. So I'll be hitting 100 tonight. Frostfire Ridge is most excellent. I'm enjoying it. Storyline's really good. And I actually have a question for you guys. And this is something that came up, and it just hit me in my head. I meant to put in the notes, but I didn't. So this isn't really spoiler, because so far, going through Draenor, who is your favorite hero to see that you from like previous games?
The one that intrigued me the most that I saw was actually Akama. From the you knew him from Black Temple as one of the broken heroes, and seeing him in actual full Draenei form was pretty cool.
Mm-hmm. Pre-broke Akama,
right?
Yeah. So I mean, for me, it's pre-broke as well. But seeing Nobundu, you know, this guy who becomes a big shaman guy.
Oh yeah, the.
And he's a vindicator, so he's like super badass. Like, I saw him, and this is coming from, like, a Horde guy. Like, I'm like, man, that is awesome.
Do you have any favorites?
I didn't really have any moment like that, mainly because when it comes to BC, the only thing I remember is, dear God, how many more quests do I have to do to raid? Oh, I'm out of here.
Yeah.
That was my experience in BC. BC literally made me quit the game, guys. Like, I pretty much said, no, I'm not doing this. I'm going back to Star Wars.
Right.
I think my favorite moment was the fact that in the middle of just Negrand, just standing there, there's a Shadow Pan warrior. What? He's just standing there like, hey, thanks for taking care of that town for us. It's like, you're a panda wearing Shadow Pan armor. I think you took a left turn at Albuquerque.
Right.
They added a monk.
Yep, we did want a monk in there. They added one.
We got monk lore. Yes.
Yes.
There we go.
One monk. Okay. So for me, I'm up to about 95 and a half-ish. problems with the servers definitely caused issues. Those were the times, the days, Thursday and Friday, where I had a lot of time. Friday was really disappointing because I waited 3 hours to get inside the server, and I got to the server, and I got the character not found, which a lot of people were having problems with.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So that was incredibly frustrating. So, but I got in Saturday. The servers were supposed to be down till 11 my time, and like at 9:30 my time, I see a tweet saying servers are up. I'm like, I'd like drop my controller and dust, and I'm like, screw it, they can kill me PvP, I don't care. Run to the computer and get started and get a full day of leveling. So that was pretty cool. Yep. Yeah, completely
those
cleared out.
Yeah, server queues were horrible. I mean, there was one time I actually had to wait 6 minutes, guys. 6 minutes to get into
my
server.
Keep in mind, the population on Adam's server is 7, and half of those are his dungeon team. Yeah. Because they don't have raid teams on his server.
Yeah, so me and Lady Chai, we rolled characters on Drendan, and I think we doubled the server population. It was pretty fun. Pretty good.
That's
why you guys got queues. Sorry about that.
Cut to Storm Rage.
Yeah. Oh, God. Poor LeBlue.
He's still stuck in the queue.
Yeah, I think he's still queued from Thursday.
He's still stuck in the queue from Saturday. Yeah.
Right.
Poor Blue.
Like, basically, he put out on Twitter the other day, it's like, so I wake up in the morning, I log on to the server, I go to work, I come back, I've only got half an hour left, guys.
You know, it was real funny. At 3 in the morning, he's asking for invites to other servers so he can CRZ on their server. And actually, I think I got him one. Someone was able to pull him over to a different server just so he could actually kill things, because it's that crazy on Storm Rage.
I had it. It was kind of weird. Wow. Like, Lady Chai's on a different server, and I had her invite me, and I was still seeing a lot of convert to raid people. So either...
Yeah, that happened. I switched over to Trollbane because there was a bugged mob. And who do I see killing the bugged mob? A convert to raid member.
Right. I'm not sure if they're like coming over to my server or not, or if it's just like it's not working. Like the CRZ is not working. I don't know what's going on.
Well, they modified it so that if you're being, you know, you'd be CRC'd like to reduce stress, but you're more likely to see people from your own guild in that CRZ zone.
But nothing, I thought it went by party leader is cross realm zones are not enabled in Draenor.
Well, this was a special thing they did that they were talking about for the server infrastructure, especially for the popular realms.
What they've done is basically kind of what like City of Heroes used to do, where they would spawn all new versions so as not to populate it, right? So you could be on Nagrand 1 or Nagrand 2 or Nagrand 3 on heavy pop servers, right?
Yeah.
I'm staring at a bugged mob. This is Soul Sisters. It's one that the only way to unbug it is you need an affliction. And apparently Warlocks just heard of affliction a couple days ago because I couldn't find one. It's like no. I'm Destro and whatever the other one is. Demon Destro. It's like, is there an affliction lock in the server? I put it out in guild chats. Like, I'm going to give you 10,000 gold if you're an affliction lock and come here and do this. And it's crickets. So I talked to a buddy of mine on Trollbane. I say, hey, invite me over. He invites me. I see everyone on Airy Peak disappear. And suddenly I'm staring at a bunch of people from Trollbane because I know the guilds at Trollbane. And there's one person from convert to raid in
there. For me, it was like she invited me, so it's supposed to go to the party leader, their server.
Yeah, so you were on Argent Dawn.
Yeah, I was on Argent Dawn, and yet I saw a ton of Airy Peak people, so I think something else happened. They have changed it, modified it somehow in Draenor because of all the server instability, so whatever.
Why kinda did weird. I not see them on the other server?
I don't know. Reasons.
Yeah, so it's like, what are the odds?
Well, I think now it's time to get caught up in the crazy whirlwind of WoW news in
Dizzying Haze.
So, prepare yourselves, guys. There was a lot of stuff that happened last weekend. Me and Adam and Duke were all at BlizzCon. We went to all the WoW panels just to bring you this information. Here is the news for monks in the World of Warcraft from BlizzCon.
Sounds accurate.
Yep. Okay. There was a little bit. We had to like squeeze the orange tight enough, just get a couple drips. So live raid. The live raid happened on Saturday morning. Is Midwinter versus Method. And the news was,
it was such a close
that
race.
That was a
oh
good
my
race.
God.
If you guys haven't seen that, if you still have the virtual ticket, go watch
fantastic.
It.
It's fantastic. It literally comes down to two botched trash pulls and who recovers faster.
Right. Both of them had rogues that both face pulled mobs. Yeah.
Like, exactly.
Wow.
If one of them hadn't face pulled, it would have been a much less close race.
Much more. Yeah. It would have been Midwinter by a couple of minutes, or it would have been Method by a couple of minutes instead.
Yeah, it was like 30 seconds. Yeah.
Method by like 15 seconds.
Yep.
Like, and honestly, it was that close.
I was hoping, because I talked to some of the Midwinter guys, and they said that if Method had beat them soundly enough, or Midwinter was ahead of them soundly enough, they were going to spawn in Dark Shamans in the middle of the final boss.
Yeah. They but had it was, that ready. They had server admins ready to just go, all right, Shamans, go.
Right, but it was close enough they didn't want to mess with it, so... But here's the monk news. Midwinter ran a Mistweaver. What?
I heard about that. Yeah.
And two Windwalkers.
Two.
Yeah.
Whoa. Not supposed to be able to do that, are you? Is that allowed?
And in the Cleave fight, the one where they had both two bosses up, they ran the Mistweaver as Windwalker. So they had three Windwalkers up because Cleave is what the fuck broken for Windwalkers right now. So, and the best part is the Mistweaver, it was Chi-Chan MW was his name. He was top on the healing meters every fight except for the one he was Windwalking. So,
and even there, he was still like top 5 DPS.
Right.
Go so, Windwalkers.
Yeah.
And I'm talking, he was not a fist, you know, there was a little bit of fist weaving, there was a lot of mist weaving, and he beat the two Disc Priests.
Yep.
That they had with them.
Yeah, so
it was fantastic. They've got the log out. I think we have the link for it, so you'll see it in the show notes. But they put their logs up on Warcraft logs. It's totally public. You go check it out there. The funny thing is that they were using the same strat they're going to use when it comes to the Mythic fight.
Yep. So there will be a little bit more craziness. Like there was one fight where there's pits of tigers, and yeah, those tigers come out in Mythic where they just stay there in Heroic. So that was actually the first time I got to see the raid. I've been purposely like not looking at stuff since I'm not the strategy guy for my raid. I kind of want to see it kind of fresh, but I watched the whole raid. It's pretty nice looking raid. It's going to be a lot of fun.
I'm all looks like a lot of fun.
As soon as I hit 100, it's every moment I got studying that.
Yeah, yeah. I will admit, it's kind of nice not doing... Mythic. You get to kind of just relax and enjoy it instead of having to study the crap out of it. So, but that's a whole new level, and a lot of people enjoy that. I would love doing it, but no one wants a Mistweaver.
Except for Mythic.
Except for Midwinter.
Midwinter.
Yeah. Method actually ran one Windwalker as well. So
token Windwalker. Everyone's running a token Windwalker.
Right. They need that movement speed, man. Give me the Wind Flurry. All right. Basically. Let's see. Warlords of Draenor launched. That's a thing. So.
Oh, I didn't notice.
Yeah.
Huh.
That's weird.
Yeah. So if you didn't know that, you can go buy it. Boost a monk. Yeah. Do it.
I boosted a monk, so now I have two high level monks on one server.
Yay! I've got two that I leveled by myself. But oh well. All right. And see, there was a hotfix that came out for Brewmasters. So, you guys, I heard you guys like mitigating damage.
Yes.
So we'll let you mitigate more damage.
Yeah, we have more armor with what? It's up 75, up to 75% from 50, and now we reduce magic damage by 15% instead of 10%.
That is a nice boost.
Yes, it is.
Very nice, considering that magic damage has always been the biggest weakness for a Brewmaster.
Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, you know, I wasn't able to test it before and after, so I'm not even sure how much it affects us with individual fights, but more is always better, so I'm not going to complain.
Yep, more damage reduction is always good. Mm-hmm. All right, as far as actual, like, WoW panel news at BlizzCon, they had the Q&As, but, the red shirt questions this year. It's so sad. My favorite was like the very first thing that Ian Hazakosa said when he came out. It was just like, hey, let's avoid class-based questions. Second question, hey, I've got this rogue. like, oh, god damn it, rogues. And then the next one was like, hey, I've got this druid. I'm like, jeez, people, come on.
Don't forget the mage who kept asking where her mana gem was.
Right. Yep. The mage asked about the mana gem. That's right.
Seriously, guys, if you're out there and you go to BlizzCon and you get in line for the Q&A, ask somebody else your question first. And if they laugh, don't ask your question.
Yeah.
Yeah. My favorite question. My favorite question was, why is Thrall the only person or the only orc that has eyebrows?
And then I found out that's not true.
Right. Yeah.
Because I was so worried about that.
I know, right?
Oh my god.
Well, then there was a second eyebrow question later in the day. Yeah. Which is relevant because as a night elf now, I realize that my eyebrows don't show up with some helmets, so I need to submit some bug reports.
Okay. Well, that's useful.
It also doesn't show up if you're clean shaven.
Yeah.
Really?
That was the most important question.
If you go with the clean shaven, your eyebrows are gone. And they're like, oh, we had to give them to Thrall. That was what the developers said.
Oh, all right. Well, I think it's time to expand our knowledge and meditate in
Transcendence.
Okay, we're going to talk today about leveling up, because I think that's what a lot of people are doing right now. And if you were already level 100, you don't really need this, so you can skip forward for a little bit. But don't, because we're funny.
All right, guys, got to go.
All right. So we're going to talk some tools, tips, tricks, step priorities, things like that. So let's go over some useful tools. I want to add this one in first. Ask Mr. Robot. Fantastic. Once you find your stat priorities, throw that in. You can get a best in slot list. You can narrow it down whether you want to do crafted items. If you just want to get your dungeon, your heroic dungeon best in slot list. If you want to get ready for raid, know what your best in slot list is there. You need to throw it in and it's... oh. Love Ask Mr. Robot, and I have...
We got to meet Mr. Robot's handlers
last
week at the World of Podcasts, and these are seriously some of the nicest people
they
I've ever met.
They are so nice, and I've got live
literally
rankings.
The nicest people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I ended up running into them a bunch of times.
Yeah.
It was like, every time they were friendly, it was so crazy, because like, you know, I met him, she's like, oh, you're on Monk Meditation, and then she's like, oh, you're on another podcast. I'm like, oh, yeah, I'm on the Nexus. So he's like, no, there's that other one where you're talking about non-gaming stuff. Like, she's like, it's like Chart. I'm like, oh, yeah, Chart Arts. I forgot about that. So I was very surprised that it's like they did their homework. And I got like the coolest print from them as well.
So they gave out these art prints to people who were on the panels at World of Podcasts. And they somehow managed to give Duke, me, and Guanchu all different prints. And all of us
totally
think,
different prints.
All of us think we got the best one.
Easily. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I know I got the best one.
Yeah. I mean, look. Brewmaster.
Yeah, that was pretty cool. I got one that was Windwalker, Brewmaster, and Mistweaver.
Yes. That one was pretty...
That one is pretty good.
All three pieces, I mean, these are all fan-submitted artwork, and it was stuff that they had put up in the World of Podcasts art exhibit. Which was absolutely fantastic. I mean, there were over 200 pieces. It was fantastic.
Yeah, I saw the pictures. Really that looked great.
Yeah.
Yeah. The room was constantly full. Just an utterly fantastic time. And I'm walking through there with Chai. And he's like, oh, damn, I didn't see that. If not, I would have put my name for that one. We're like, oh, well, this guy, some Michael dude's got it. It's like, oh, well, maybe next time. Or, you know, we know it's public, so, you know, we'll have to find it. And sure enough, 10 minutes later, it's like, oh, we got a gift for you. Here. He opens it up. It's the one he wanted. That Ask Mr. Robot is so damn good at optimizing.
I know.
How to optimize gifts.
Yep.
Yeah, no, I did the same exact thing. I walked up and I said, man, that's my favorite. And I'm like, too bad I'm doing world of, like working here, kind of. I'm like, I don't want to take away from the people coming. And then I got it. And I was like, you are the smartest person ever, robot.
So that was all very useful information on how to level up. Let's see.
Sorry. Their website is beyond fantastic, and to see that the people behind that website are also just as awesome is great, because you like these community-run programs, and to see that they have reached this level of success, that they have worked really, really hard to do it, and are just absolutely amazing people also, it's easy for me to throw my support behind them. Mm-hmm. Very easy.
All right, and Duke, you want to go over the next one? Because I'm going to be throwing an Ask Mr.
One.
Robot's code into chat here. So you go ahead.
Good luck, chat room. Guys, we have a stack of them. We're going to be tossing them out over the next couple of weeks. So the next tool is one that still kind of scares me a little. SimCraft for your stat weights. It's a really good tool, but I'm still trying to figure out how to use it because I click a button and the stat weights it gives me totally differ from the stat rates I'm seeing out there. So I'm just kind of wondering what the heck I'm doing wrong. But as soon as I figure it out and I've got a wrench, I'll let you guys know.
Good.
Yeah, it's I know that Delritha has been working a lot on the Windwalker and the Brewmaster one. Mistweaver, I wouldn't trust that one yet. He's still working on that one.
Even he admits it's basically not really there. It's coming soon, though. As soon as he finishes, he'll get it up and running. But it's a fantastic tool. There's all sorts of different modes that you can do stuff. You can simulate different kinds of boss fights and kind of get an idea for there. Because even though we're going to talk to you about, hey, you know, this is your stat priority and you want this and you want this and you want this, your stat weights actually change with every piece of gear you get.
So
it's something that you're going to run often. And then what do you do with those stat weights?
You throw them in Asmus Robot.
Bingo.
Yep. Now, there was one piece of information, one piece that came out of that Q&A that was actually really interesting. And someone asked the developers, what is your simulation tool? Do you use something like SimCraft? Do you use just spreadsheets, anything like that? They said, we use a live version of WoW with bots. So it's actually running the server itself. Seems like really inefficient, but very reliable results. Right? You're going to get the most accurate results, but it's going to take you in real time. You can't smash 10,000 of them at the same time.
Yeah.
And so that they said that's how they do their simulation. That's how they get the numbers they do, which really intrigued me. It seemed like a very different method to do things, but it was kind of fun.
Well, it also lets them simulate lag. It lets them simulate being in the world and maybe, okay, here's high FPS, here's low FPS, that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So it's a really good tool for them, and I know there was a few tweets out during beta that each developer has their own little spot that they like going to, and just doing stuff there. You know, Celestalon said his favorite spot was out by Winterspring. You know, so it's kind of interesting to hear these people. It's like, yeah, I just spawn an instance, log into the server real quick, make some changes, see what's going on, and then go right back to the code, which has got to be one of the most annoying code bases ever.
Yeah.
Well, you know, you can't change the original bag size because of it, so.
Right.
It's not like bag size equals 16 is somewhere in the code. It's like, no, it's like much more in depth. Like, if they change the bag size, forget it.
Yeah. I was just going to say Anixia.
I like that.
Yeah. All right. And let's see. One thing I really want to bring up is this lovely mod called Handy Notes. Have you guys heard of this?
Yes.
Yes. And I have a small... I was talking to good friend, teammate Spencer. It's Spencer HD, one of the guys who does all the inside stuff in the CTR Guild about this particular end. I kind of have to agree that it's a great resource, but you realize that Blizzard already has this in the game, right?
Well, oh, yeah, you have to get these items that let you do the treasure finders and stuff like that, right?
Yeah, the treasure maps.
Yeah, you finish a zone, you clear it in a lore master style, then you can go to Ashran and apparently buy a map for 100 gold to show you where all the treasure is.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but by that time... That is pretty cool. However, by that time, you've out-leveled the zone, and the gear that drops from those rares and those items and those treasures you get aren't as useful. So they're going to be most useful when you pick them up.
Be honest here. That gear will last you about an hour and a half.
This is true. This is true. But it's better to last you an hour and a half than not be useful whatsoever.
You can always DE it, which takes us into the next guide.
Right. WoWhead Garrison Guides. So... there are some really great guides out there. I'm going to link one in the show notes in particular that says, let's see, what was the name of it? It said, garrisons for what you like to play. Mm-hmm. So there, you gave so many, it says for content you like. So there are so many different ways to build your garrison. If you're interested in raiding, it kind of gives you some of the buildings that are going to be useful for raiding. If you like pets, if you like mounts, if you like, you know, so there's all these different ways you can build your garrison to really help you out for what you like to do, which I think is really cool. That's one of the best features of the garrison is how expandable it is. So like, I went with an enchanting one because I want to be able to disenchant all my crap.
Yeah, that's
because the materials are so expensive.
Right. Yeah.
And just being able to do the cheap enchants for yourself, it's like, it's fantastic.
Yeah, because I don't want to burn like all these really expensive mats on something that I'm going to, you know, replace on week one in Heimal. So
exactly.
Get the crap enchants to start off with and then get the good ones later. So, So we didn't really just explain what Handy Notes did, so let me go over that really quick. Handy Notes and Handy Notes Draenor, they're the combination add-ons. What they'll do is they'll place a little note on your map as well as your mini-map anytime there's a treasure, a rare, or a like interactable object or event. Mm-hmm. It will like place that on the map so you can, like, when you're running around, you say, oh, there's something over here. It doesn't really tell you like if it's up or down or anything like that. So every so often you run to a spot, you're like, where the hell? And you look up and there's a giant mushroom. You're like, ah, bet it's up there. And you have to figure out the way up there. But it's really cool. And there's so many things. Like, you go into a new zone and it's just like your map is completely littered with stuff. It's like, take the Timeless Isle and like times it 1,000 by density of where stuff is. It's like every 5 feet you're tripping over something. So yeah, and that can get you a ton of XP. It can get you a ton of really good items, pets, mounts, things like that. So yeah, it's definitely worth checking out. All right, so we're gonna go over stat priorities now. Keep in mind that these stat priorities are kind of your overall thing. I see the Windwalker and here is going to put you single target in AoE, but these are just kind of your baseline, what you should kind of gear for as you start leveling up. Once you get to 100 and start getting into raids and dungeons and stuff like that, definitely use Simcraft, use other things to figure out your actual weights. So I'm going to go to Brewmaster first.
Yeah, I mean, one thing that, you know, I had it there and I took it off was bonus armor. You don't have to worry about that leveling up. You're not going to get a lot of it anyways. But I would recommend haste just for energy regen, so that way you kind of keep at it a little bit longer. You want to use versatility because it's damage and healing, because as a brewmaster, you want to grab a lot of stuff. So
damage reduction.
So you want to be able to, you know, survive. And then crit, just because it's a great stat for damage and actually, you know, survivability in terms of getting your stacks of the brew that, for some reason, it slipped my mind right now, and that's
elusive.
Horrible. Elusive, yeah, it's elusive in my head. So you know, so you can pop that. I found, and I think I wrote this, but I found coming from I boosted a level 90, and I found Brewmaster was the better option because of the low amount of gear you have. You don't kill things that fast as Windwalker. So for me, Brewmaster ended up working out well anyways, because you could survive a little bit more until you start getting more gear. Mm-hmm. So.
All right, I'm going to go to Windwalker. Duke, you want to go over the single target?
Sure. So the Windwalker stats right now assume that you're going to be taking Ascension, because it kind of speeds up our play a little bit, and that you're going to take Chi Explosion, because the others just don't really compare, except for really, really, really niche places. So for single target, it's really complicated. You want multi-strike. You want all the multi-strike. We don't have to worry about cleave. For cleave, we got a special. It's a spell. We call it Storm, Earth, and Fire. It's amazing. But yeah, you want to gather up all the multi-strike gear you want. Crit and versatility. Some people prefer crit. Some people prefer versatility. They're kind of interchangeable in what they're doing at that point. If you want to go straight damage, then you're going to go with crit. If you're looking for versatility to also help you help your healers out and try and survive a little bit, then versatility is better. It really depends on your own personal survivability. After that, you're going to want haste, just enough to kind of boost you up so that your energy regen feels fine. And then after that, if you really, really, really want mastery, but mastery is so kind of useless for Windwalkers right now, I think it sims out at a stat rate of like 0.25 when everything else is around 1.5, yeah. Is what Callie said. So, like, honestly, you'd have to get like 6-7 points of mastery to make up 1 point of any of the other stats. So please, just if you see mastery, just burn it.
Yep. All right, Air, you want to go over area of effect fights?
Yeah. So for the AOE, the good fun stuff, we're gonna be still want multi-strike. More multi-strike, add a little bit more multi-strike for fun, and when you have enough of that, add more multi-strike. In fact, if you're in Shadow Moon, you got a little multi-strike
buff, yeah.
Blessing from Kadal?
Kara. Mm-hmm.
Kara.
Kara. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, go get that buff, because that'll be help you out, you know, early leveling for, as you start off as well, too, at some of the shrines you see. But after that, multi-strike, then go to crit, hit up versatility, which is still a little bit better than haste at that point. But, you know, relatively equal, and you just want to be comfortable with everything. And finally, mastery, and we don't really care about that so much.
You know what the best part is if you are a Mistweaver and Windwalker bow specs, the gear is exactly the same. It's fantastic.
Nice.
Multi-strike. We want all the multi-strike as a Mistweaver. Give me more multi-strike. And then
especially
crit.
For the rem procs.
Right. And then crit, because mana T, yay. Versatility, and then haste, and then just burn all the mastery. Just like you said with the Windwalker. It's almost exactly the same stat priority. So this will be really handy for those who like to bounce between them. You can use all the same armor. It's great. All right. And that's, for Mistweaver, it's, depending on which talent you take, which it should be, Pool of Mist, because that's like the only good one right now. But depending on how much you stance dance and how much you spend in crane stance, those weights can change, but that should be a good starting point for everybody.
The specific weights will change. You might see crit and versatility swap. You might see haste come up a little bit, but in general, this is what you're looking for.
Yep.
Yeah.
All right, so let's just go over some leveling tips as you level up. Hopefully you got your heirloom from 6.0. If not, you'll still get plenty of weapons, especially from the little treasures on the ground if you got handy notes. Lots and lots of weapons. Biggest tip I can give, touch of death everything. Like, everything. Because you can walk up to the rares and
so
go
great.
Poke, and it dies.
So nice.
It's especially great if you're Alliance, like we are, except for Adam, but we forgive him. And you've got some orc coming up behind you who's like, hold on, I just need to tap him. Touch of death.
Exactly what I was going to say. I love that.
All right. Let's see. Let's go over some...
you share the loot. It's not like he'll take your loot, but...
Yeah.
No.
Yep. All right. Brewmaster tips. Why don't you?
Well, one big thing is the greatness of being a tank at this point is the insta-queue of the dungeon. So if you're kind of tired of the slog of questing, if that's not your thing, you'll just be a brewmaster, go in. It's easy enough. The fights aren't that difficult. It's a good time. I was able to bring some friends into the different dungeons because they were like, oh, it's like a half hour wait for me to get into a dungeon. I was like, come along, I will show you the greatness of being a brewmaster. And so that worked really well. The other stuff, like I said, pretty much goes with your stats. Is if you can get the versatility, just being able to survive long enough to kill things sometimes is helpful. I feel like the mobs just hit a lot harder and aggro quicker in Draenor for me than in previous expansions. So that's why Brumass worked out for me. I think it might be that I'm a Tauren and a nice sirloin steak sitting right there. They're like, let's go get that.
Jeez.
So, yeah, those are the basic ones. You know, dungeons, I like doing dungeons a lot, so that's a big one for me.
Yes, it's good to go in as either a Mistweaver or a Brewmaster if you want to get quick quick dungeon queues, especially Brewmaster. You get really quick ones there.
As a Windwalker, what you do is that you queue for a dungeon, right? And you queue as DPS, and right now the queue is about an hour. And the nice thing is that it's about long enough to kind of remind you, hey, you're questing, and it just dings on your screen, and suddenly it's like, oh, I'm awake, sorry, I started nodding off after killing 37 Talbucks.
Right.
I've done no dungeon so far. I've done strictly questing.
Yeah, all questing for me.
I've done one. I did Skyreach for my ring.
Right. I'm looking forward to getting in there and doing it.
I need to do the dungeons while they're at the level areas. I got to go back and do the SMV dungeon. It reminds me. Okay, thanks for the reminder.
Yeah. Yeah, I need to go do that too. For Mistweaver leveling, you have this wonderful utility you can use called Windwalker. And I would heavily suggest leveling as Windwalker unless you're doing dungeons. While Crane's Dance, you're not going to die. You're just going to go so much faster than Windwalker. So just do it.
It's the same as Brewmaster, because I leveled as Brewmaster in Pandaria, and it was just great vengeance whoring the whole time, basically. Mm. And
you don't get that.
Without the vengeance, it's like, oh, I hit like a floppy noodle.
Mm-hmm.
They're still doing decent DPS. I mean, especially if you're over gearing it, you can go as Brewmaster. You can pull everything and you're not going to die. And one of the worst things that happened, the worst tragedy, the horn doesn't work on mobs over level 93.
Mm-hmm. Wait, the battle horn?
Yeah. Air's like, no!
I'm reading the tooltip right now, actually. And
yeah.
There's a lot of abilities that basically the higher up you go, the closer to 100 you go, the less effect it happens. Like,
yeah.
Capacitance on your legendary gem. I haven't seen the proc in like a couple hours.
Yeah.
They turned that off. There's a hot fix to get rid of that at level 100 because it was proccing for a while. Same with the cloak.
Yeah, the cloak. I think the last time the cloak proc'd for me was right in the middle of one of the last quests in the Grand where you're an OSHA gun. And that's it. It's like, okay, now the cloak is literally just stats.
Yeah. So a couple other tips. Keep in mind that Flying Serpent Kick, if you're doing Windwalker, goes over water. So if you're trying to get somewhere, because there's a lot of water.
Do not glyph it.
Yeah. Don't glyph.
Because if you glyph it, you're going to enter combat as soon as you hit somebody. If you're not glyphed, you can just kind of fly right by them.
Yep. And it's, it's really useful, especially in Shadow Moon. There's a lot of water around that place. So
Nagrand, too.
Yeah.
Nagrand, the one thing it has is there's this giant hole right outside the Talari station where it's like, da-da-da, walking. That's a cliff.
Splat.
Bad things down there. I think I saw an ogre.
Yep. Other than that, it's just like, just have fun leveling up. When you get Transcendence, the perk, that's instant cast, so it's a lot of fun. So if you have to jump off a cliff somewhere to get something, make sure you put your clone up top, and then you can pop right back up. So it's fun times. All right, any other tips for leveling, guys?
Like you just said, just take your time. Raids don't open till December, right? So you're going to have, it's going to be quiet this week. Next week is Thanksgiving, I heard, in the U.S.
Yeah.
And just take your time and enjoy it. I mean, honestly, it's such a fun romp. One leveling tip that I have, it can sometimes be, because there's no linear progression like there was in Pandaria, where you're basically led from quest hub to quest hub, and there's one correct path to go through. Go through and finish a chapter in a chunk of time. And each chapter will take you about an hour and a half to finish or so. At like the top end, that's taking your time speed. Once you finish a chapter, you always go back to your garrison or your outpost. And that's the point where you can kind of like relax and say, okay, I got this.
Right.
So that'll help you. If you're breaking up your questing in the middle of quest hubs, it's going to feel kind of disjointed and weird to you. And you're going to lose parts of what you're doing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, another tip, if you pick the lumber mill in your garrison for your small building, you'll have enough resources where you can use the level up potion. There is a...
No, don't do that. Yeah. Never do that.
If your goal is to get up to 100 as quickly as possible, that's an option for you, but you will be starved for resources if you get 100. But yeah, the lumber mill lets you get a lot more resources, so...
You'll get your level 2 garrison at like level 91 or something like that, level 92. Like before you leave Shadow mm-hmm. Moon, you'll get your level 2. Oh, you want a level 3? Well, that's 5,000 gold and 2,000 resources. Oh, you spent it on potions.
Right. But you can really maximize it. You do a ton of quests, pop that potion, get in there, do a dungeon. So there's definitely...
Yeah.
Just know that you can get that.
If you combine that 20% with the brewery that you can get in Spires of Arrak, you now have a 40% XP buff.
Yeah. So definitely ways to level up quickly if that's your goal. But honestly, it's like I'm 2 zones in, I'm halfway to 100. So not really that needed.
Yeah.
Have fun. The storytelling is great. The zones are fun. All the rares and everything. If you have ADD, I feel for you in this expansion.
And you don't feel pressured to do the bonus quests that are out there. The bonus
objectives that are out there.
They give a ton of XP, but I think I did one my entire time, and I still got to 100 at the end of Nagrand like you're supposed to.
Right. Yeah, but it's like, I was doing Gorgrond with Lady Chai mm-hmm. yesterday, and we got out there and we got like the place where it says, okay, go to one of these four hubs, and we're like, okay, well, we'll head towards this hub, and an hour later we're like, oh yeah, we never actually did the quest, did we? So we just got, it's like, oh, rare over here, ooh, treasure over here, ooh, rare over here, bonus objective here, oh boy. So yeah. Squirrel.
It's funny because
shiny object syndrome is awful.
I love the bonus objectives, and I'd tell people to go do them because I found them fun. Just because it's like
great fun. But if you don't want to do them because you just want to keep experiencing the story, do that. It's not wrong.
Play how you want to play, man.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. You're going to get 100 at the right time.
Yep. All right. Yeah, Aaron, do you have any tips?
Go out, explore, have fun. Use your, if you're windwalking, Fist of Fury, everything whenever you can, because things just melt. Again, handy notes is nice if you want to go that route. And yes, it's nice to have because you do experience. And I like the bonus objectives. I like in Gorgrond how you can go kill those extra big monsters. Mm-hmm. You kill them all, there's an achievement.
Yes, and Gorgrond Hunter.
You get extra, you just bonus, it's a quest for each one you kill for 20
bonus XP.
K experience. So, I mean,
bonus experience and garrison resources.
Yep.
Yeah, everything you see, go up and kill.
So
and
if you're
play with the garrison.
If you're going to mess with that XP potion, that's a great thing to do in Gorgrond, is to go do all of those guys and wait to turn them in the exact same time. So it's a good way to maximize that potion if you're going to do that.
I was going to say, there's one thing I forgot. Is that, if you pick the Lumberyard, we get the Goblin Treader. If you choose... that's in Gorgrond, and then in Nagrand, you can get the Demolisher. Mm-hmm. Don't forget to use them. They kill things fast.
Yeah, and with the Shredder, you can fly.
You can fly with the Shredder.
Yeah.
It is so awesome. So don't forget to use them, because during Gorgrond, I kept forgetting to use it, and I'm like, man, I could have just moved a little quicker, flew a little higher.
Yeah, I felt like Iron Man. There was this one area where there's just a ton of little flower guys. What are those called? Podlings? Is that what they're called?
Podlings.
Yeah, they're like they're like the Murlocs.
The audio behind them is so great.
Yeah, but it's like that is such a creepy thing in Shadow Moon. I'm not going to spoil it for you guys, but when you guys do Shadow Moon, that Podling quest is like the most creepy thing in the world. Oh, man. But there's this area in Gorgrond where there's a whole ton of podlings and stuff like that. And so it's like you pop into that Shredder, you go flying around, you land and just nuke like entire waves of these guys in one shot. It's like, ooh, so much fun. So much fun.
What's nice is that the button for your, that you originally get for your garrison button that changes depending on what...
Does anyone know where to find that in the spellbook if you happen to delete it?
It's not in the spellbook. You have to grab it from the special action button that pops out.
Okay.
But once you do and you put it on one of your bars, like Air says, it will change to the appropriate garrison or outpost ability in whatever zone you're in.
What happens if you take it off? Does it go back into the special action?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That's cool.
Yeah, it's always, you have to turn that off, right? But you can always turn it back on. And I think there's like, it's like slash use garrison ability or something like that. Mm-hmm. There's like, you can macro it to have.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so cool. There's a lot of ways for you to access that button if your UI doesn't show you that.
Mm-hmm.
And one macro will work for all of them.
Yep.
Okay. All right, well, it's time now to travel to the Peak of Serenity, the home for all monks in...
Zen Pilgrimage.
Monks, assemble!
That was really fun shouting that at BlizzCon out in the fountain. And we had one monk.
We found one!
Yeah, we had monk. Like, I had announced on Twitter, we were doing a group photo, and I had shouted that, and we had some other monk come over that wasn't following me on Twitter. He's like, oh, I'm a monk. I'll get a picture.
It's so, like, oh.
That works.
Is this the monk meetup? It's like, yeah, you found it. Go on it.
That works. All right. So we do have some questions from the dojo. Valen asked if we're enjoying Mistweaver. I will be honest. I have not touched Mistweaver whatsoever. I'm waiting until I hit 100 because Windwalker is just that much easier to level up with. So if I get into a dungeon, which I'm planning on doing, I'm going to switch over to Mistweaver. The 6.0 Mistweaver I did in Siege, that was a lot of fun. So I'm looking forward to playing with more multi-strike and versatility. So I'm really looking forward to that. So I'll keep you guys abreast next episode when I've had a chance to do more heroics. Let's see. Valen also asks, how do you guys manage Chi Explosion with Fists of Fury on cooldown? We have one Windwalker at 100.
Cooldown. It's 25 seconds. So pretty much whenever you don't have the chi to spend, whenever it's on cooldown, you're going to use Blackout Kick anyways. So you want to build up to about 3 chi, and the 3G chi explosion seems to be the sweet spot for the spell.
Mm-hmm. Unless you're doing mass AoE, then you want the 4.
Unless you're doing mass, yeah. Then at that point, you want to go all the way up to 4. But the nice thing is that when you do chi explosion, you can now proc Combo Breaker Chi Explosion, which gives you 2 free Chi.
Yeah. It's really nice. Okay, WMD0704 asks in the dojo. That's a tongue twister. How do you feel with the awkwardness of the Renewing Mist procs from Multistrike? Not really.
Did you say it's awkward?
It is if you don't have a weak aura for it. Okay. I built a weak aura for it because it's, if you're used to healing with it in the old 5.4 method, it's weird having that muscle memory where you hit it every 8 seconds, right? And you have this muscle memory tuned in where you're not looking at it after you hit it, and then it will pop right back up. So I just built a weak aura. Every time it pops up and isn't available, it like screams in my face. It's like, hey! Cast me. So it really isn't that awkward after you get used to it. So, but I've only got to play with it with one trinket of multi-strike. And it proc'd a significant amount of times with that low of multi-strike. So when I start building towards it and having that as my primary stat, that's going to be really interesting. And especially in a mythic environment with 20 people, if it procs enough and you hit it with the Thunder Focus T, you're going to have it on a good chunk of the raid, which is going to lessen your effectiveness of uplift. So you may have to get in the habit, if you know the fight and know it's coming, you may have to get in the habit of not hitting it when it comes up. If you know it's coming and you know how many people are going to need heals and how much your uplift is going to do, you may have to not hit it when it's available. So I'll have to play with that and see how it is. My team's only 15 players, so... that's going to be even more of a concern for me if I'm blanketing the raid and not doing much AoE healing. So I will keep you guys abreast on that. All right. And I have a giveaway to do. Oh, sorry, yeah, had to get it. So this is a World of Warcraft Warlords of Draenor Brady Games signature guide, strategy guide.
Oh, there's something special about that guide.
There is.
Apparently.
See, I don't know if my camera will focus enough. Where is it?
Not a chance in hell.
Okay. Whatever. My name's in there, so that's the...
Yes. If you're wondering who wrote the monk section, that would be Mr. Chai T.
Yeah,
here.
So yell at me if I got it wrong. There was one typo I got... not typo, but there was one thing that didn't survive the perk snipping that I missed, and I was so upset. And I caught it, and I was like, I messaged the person that was handling it, and they're like, oh, it's already gone to print. I'm like, no! I have an error! No! So, whatever.
Iteration, man.
Yeah, iteration. Yeah. And that was one of the first things cut. Yeah, I just missed it.
One of the first things they do is put out digital errata that you can download, print, and kind of keep around if you want to, or better yet, just stay tuned to Monk Meditation, and we'll tell you what Chai got wrong.
Yes. So, Energizing Brew doesn't give you multi-strike anymore.
Nope.
There you go. yeah, so I got to do the Monk Guide for both, for all three specs. That was a lot of fun, especially running the Mistweaver one, since there was a lot more changes there. So it's really geared towards someone who just boosted a Monk. So if you have a friend that just starting a Monk, point him that way. Have some really good information there. Also, this book has a lot of information on like garrisons and things like that. So it's going to be your strategy guide. So they gave me a couple of them. I'm going to keep one for myself for posterity, but I'm going to give the other one away. So if you would like one of these lovely things, and if you want to, I don't know why you would. If you want me to desecrate it with my horrible scribble, I'll...
Signed copy.
We just lost audio on Chai.
Yeah, I just accidentally hit my mute button with the book.
The world doesn't want you to sign it.
No.
To shut it off.
Yes.
Karma.
Yeah, so if you want my scribble, I'll do it. But if not, it's up to you. Winner gets to decide. If you want it, you can enter in through themonkmeditation.com. There's a post on there right now. So you can go sign up for it there. And you'll get an entry. And we'll have a winner next show. So,
good stuff.
Yeah, it's open. I think I opened it to US and Canada because I don't want to pay international postage. But if you're in the EU, you want to enter, if you're listening to this, go right ahead. I will ship it to you.
Also, we have something else we're going to be giving away next show.
Let me get on your camera.
Murgle.
Murgle.
The BlizzCon exclusive Funko Pop figure.
Mm-hmm.
We'll be talking about that as we get closer to the show, but we're going to make sure that the person who gets this, A, did not go to BlizzCon because you don't need one. They were all literally the same that you got pulled out of the box. And two, is a well-deserving monk.
Yes.
Okay, LeBlue wins it.
Yep.
No, I'm joking.
I thought you said well-deserving monk.
Yeah, I know. That's the joke.
That's the joke.
So all right. We'll be giving that away next episode, too. Probably do it live during the show, either before or after. We'll figure that out and let you know how you can win it.
And as another hook for listening live, we're going to have a guest from Midwinter join us.
Yes.
Very cool.
Live at BlizzCon. We got to chat with him a little bit. He was a really cool guy. So tune in for that.
Play Cards Against Humanity with him.
Yeah, he was so tired, though. Oh, my God. Yeah.
It kind of started early for him.
Yeah. So Wise Man asked in the dojo as well, I've heard Russian Jade Wind isn't good for sustained Windwalker AoE, since Chi Gen from Jab 4 Chi Explosion is greater than Russian Jade Wind damage. Confirmed?
Yes.
Rushing
Jade Wind is the awful. Absolutely. Just use Swen. If you really need more than like two or three, use Storm, Earth, and Fire. Otherwise than that, you're using a 4 Chi Explosion. And it's going to out-damage anything that you can do with Rushing Jade Wind.
Yeah. So hopefully they will tune that, because I like having more than one choice in a tier. So
yeah,
let's hope
the level 90 and the level 100 talents for Windwalker, there's really one choice, and the other ones are kind of traps.
Yeah.
Hmm.
All right. Well, I think that does it for this show. It's time to put the brew away. So everyone, please rate us on iTunes, Stitcher, subscribe on YouTube, or on Twitch. It really does help a lot. We really appreciate it. Does anyone have anything to shout out for Duke?
Just want to give a good shout out to the Midwinter guys that we hung out with on Saturday night, Monkio and Mendenbar. Mm-hmm. Monkio's the one that we're going to have next week talking to us about how both Mistweavers and Windwalkers can do at a mythic level. And they were absolute fantastic guys. We had a blast playing Cards Against Humanity with them.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what we did instead of the concert, and I do not feel like we missed out on anything. I would do that over again, and I'm looking forward to next year.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. More monks next year. All right, Guanchu?
Shout out to everybody I met at BlizzCon. It was great. Everyone from Chaos Gaming Media, people who show up at World of Podcasts, d20crit.com, everyone. Awesome people. Also want to shout out to the one person, and I didn't get the person's name, or I forgot at this point, that recognized my voice while I was talking before a panel started, and I was like super excited. Like you're Adam Eastwood. You're from the Nexus podcast. I'd know your voice anywhere. I was so excited. It was like I'm internet famous. I've made it, guys. I have made it.
I got yelled at. I heard somebody yelling, Daikatsu! It's like, oh, I wonder who they're yelling about. Daikatsu! Oh, wait, that's my name. What the hell? How do you know me?
It was so cool. So cool. So much fun.
Absolutely awesome. Fantastic time. Absolutely. I'm still recovering from the weekend of just how absolutely awesome it was.
Yep. We're making Air sad. Air, do you have any shout-outs?
Oh, no, just thanks to the leveling buddies I have who helped me out in the world. Thanks to the other CTR guildies who aren't putting spoilers in the chat.
Yes.
But no.
All two of them.
Well, you know. Shout out to you guys listening. We had a kind of a smaller crew in the dojo today, but thanks
everyone's
guys
leveling.
For chiming in. Everyone's leveling right now. Right. Yeah, that's what's happening. So,
the people in the dojo are the ones waiting for their queue to pop. That's who we have. That's who we have.
Yeah, if you guys have a queue, good luck. It should get better. And yeah, good luck.
And take those free character migrations when they offer them. There are servers without queues. It does exist.
Come to Drendon.
Yeah, go to Drendon.
There's a server first mythic achievement still, yeah?
Yeah, the realm first mythic achievements still exist, and they will continue to exist.
So any team that transfers will be out of that running.
No.
Because of the month-long wait you have. Or they have 2 weeks to do it still.
I think, yes, you're right. There is that month-long wait. But I think that's only for paid transfers. When it comes to free transfers, there is no wait.
Interesting, okay.
Yeah, so I'll do it. Yeah, I definitely want to give a shout out to all the monks who showed up at BlizzCon. The picture was fantastic. I got to hang out with a ton of people. Allie, Jade Dot, Zels, Ivy, Geth. You guys were all fantastic to me, and all the people I didn't mention. I put you in pictures. I love you all. You guys were all fantastic. It was a ton of fun, a great weekend, so I look forward to doing it again. LeBlue had a shout-out as well. He wanted to shout-out to Seraphis from the Sundering Podcast and Catalyst Gaming Media for helping him actually complete quests by letting him play on the Dalaran server. So shout-out to Seraphis.
How does Seraphis get the shout-out? I got them two connected.
All right, you get a shout-out too, Adam.
Good.
There, all right. All right. Well, as part of the Monk community, if you have a blog, website, or person you want to see on the show, reach out to us via email at show@monkmeditation.com. The Monk community is the best one in the World of Warcraft. We want to showcase it. Duke, how can the dojo best reach us?
Well, you can find us on Twitter. You can find the show at monk_meditation. You can follow Chai T at WowMonk. Air can be found at AirWalker. I can be found at DaikatsuCTR. Guanchu is at Geek of Random, and LeBlue is at Kagurai_LeBlue.
Alright, thank you all for listening. You can watch us live in 2 weeks, Monday, December 1st at 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 p.m. Pacific, 100 UTC, at twitch.tv/wowmonk. You can join us with Monkio, special guest from Midwinter. You can also catch us at monkmeditation.com for all the ways to listen and watch the show, as well as the giveaway for this signature guide. Monk Meditation is part of Catalyst Gaming Media. For other great gaming blogs, podcasts, and events, visit catalystgamingmedia.com. That wraps up this episode of Monk Meditation.
May your brews be strong and your heart stronger.